In this video, I'll show you three effective methods that you can use to reduce your 3ds Max file size significantly, just like this. In fact, this method helped me reduce my 5GB 3D scene to less than 500MB. This will help you make your 3ds Max file smaller, conserve computer resources, and speed up your workflow. This video is sponsored by The Great Catalog, a 3D models platform that offers thousands of free and paid 3D models for CG artists and 3ds Max users. What makes this platform even better and stand out is its GC Merger script, a 3ds Max script that will help you quickly and easily insert 3D models into your scene directly from The Great Catalog library. All you'd want to do is to download the model once, and then whenever you want to use it, you just need to click on the Merge button. This will save you time and help you avoid the hassle of downloading the model and zipping it, merging it to your scene, and then importing its textures and maps. This script does it all for you automatically. Getting started is a breeze. Simply head to greatcatalog.net/3dmax-merger, download the GC Merger script, load it to your 3ds Max directly. Sign into your account and you are good to go. 3ds Max scenes consist of geometry and other elements such as lights and materials. The file size is most affected by the geometry or objects in the scene, which are made of vertices, edges, and polygons or faces. It is not about how large or big the object is, it is about how many vertices and polys the object contains. The greater the number of polygons in your project, the larger the file size will be. A small vase in the middle of a table can be more heavy than the table itself. To see how heavy or light a model is, you need to see its statistics. To display the statistics of the scene on the viewport, simply hit the number 7 on the keyboard or click on the plus sign in the upper left corner of the viewport. Hover over XView and click Show Statistics. To show the statistics of selected objects, click on the plus sign in the upper left corner of the viewport. Go down to Configure Viewport, go to Statistics, select Total Plus Selection. Next, click on Show Statistics in Active View, and finally click OK. Here is a file that I will work on today. It is made by this guy. He's a great guy. Go and support him. I will leave a link to his Facebook page and to the scene source to download it if you need to in the description box. To demonstrate the ideas behind the three methods, I will make three copies of the scene file. I will name them method 1, method 2, and method 3. And the name of the original file will be original file. As you can see, all files have the same size. Before we get into it, please keep in mind that these methods don't improve or speed up the render time. Rather, they help optimize your workflow. If you want to see videos for faster render time, check out the description box. That being said, let's see the first method on the list. Method 1, use an instance instead of copy. When you clone an object using the copy option, you copy all the data inside it, as well as its size. However, when you clone an object using the instance option, doesn't increase the file size because it references the original object's data instead of duplicating it. It shares the same geometry data at no additional size. This method is very helpful when you want to make multiple copies of an object, such as when you are working on restaurant projects and want to make many copies of the same table and chairs. But keep in mind that when you change one instance by applying or adjusting, for example, a modifier, all the other instances change with it. First, let's delete all similar models, but keep just one. Next, hold the Shift key and drag the model in the direction you want. When the clone option pops up, choose the option instance, and then determine how many copies you want. Lastly, click OK. Repeat this process wherever you want to make an instance copy. As you can see, the file size is still the same, but let's see it after we save the scene. Now the file size has been reduced to more than half, and when I render the scene, it is identical to the original file. Nothing has changed. Now let's go to method number 2, use proxy for high poly models. Proxy objects are simplified versions of high poly models. The idea behind it is that you take a heavy model and export it as a mesh with a low poly model, then you import it to the scene as a low poly model. But when you render the scene, it will load the detailed model only when needed, which is when rendering. This method can be applied to all objects on your scene, but since the small objects won't have a huge effect on the file size, you may want to use it only with complex models. The first step is to select the model that you want to proxy and isolate it. Next, ungroup all the group inside the model and then attach all its components together. Select one of its components and convert it to editable poly or edit poly if it is not already. Next, go to its parameters on the Modify tab, scroll down, and click on the small attach list box beside the attach option. On the pop-up window, click on Ctrl A to select all the model elements and click attach. And that's why we isolated the model, to select all the elements on the viewport. Finally, leave the attach option as default, mount your material IDs to material, and click OK. Wait until the object components are attached together, and you can now undo the model isolation. Next up, as the proxy model doesn't hold the materials on the model, you need to store the materials of the model before the proxy step. Open the material editor, select a new slot, and pick up the materials from the object. If you change the object scale, you need to reset its X form to the scaled size. Otherwise, the proxied object will be imported with the original scale. To do so, select the model, go to Utilities, Reset X form, and click on Reset Selected. To export the model for proxy, select the model, right mouse click, and choose Vray Mesh Export. In this example, I use Vray, but you can use any render engine or tool that supports this feature, such as Corona Render. If the Vray Mesh Export option is missing, you can show it by going to Scripting, Max Script Listener, type in Vray Mesh Export, two brackets, and press the Enter button. When you do that, you should see the word OK. On the Vray Mesh Export, you can select the folder where you want to save the exported mesh and other options. But the most important is the Max Preview Faces, where you specify how many faces or pulleys should the proxy hold. You don't need to go far with it. When you reduce it significantly, you can even see the model in the viewport. Here I changed this value to 5000 faces. Now go to the Create panel, Geometry. From the drop-down panel, choose Vray. Click on Vray Proxy, and then click on anywhere inside the viewport. The computer browser will instantly show up. Select the proxy file that you exported and click Open. The proxy file will be imported, and you can see that it didn't exceed the faces that I specified when exporting. Now all you want to do is to adjust it at the object horizontally and vertically. Remove the original model. Do the same for the rest of the models. When you save the file, you will see that the size has been reduced significantly. Let's see the render. Oh, don't forget to assign the materials you picked area to the model again. Cool, the final render is great. Now let's move on to method 3, which is using external references. Xrefs are like magic when it comes to managing complex scenes. They are essentially a way to link external 3ds Max files to your main scene. It reduces duplication of objects and geometry, which in turn keeps your file size in check. You can import an Xref and it becomes part of your scene without actually being physically inside it. Before you make Xref files, make sure that the objects are in their places. You can't move Xref files or even select it. Here is how it works. Let's open the file 3, select the large models on your scene, those which you want to use as Xrefs, and export them. When saving, choose the Save Selected option, choose the file you want to save it in, name the file, and click Save. Next, delete the selected objects from your scene. Next, import the file as Xref. You can drag and drop the file inside the scene, and choose the Xref file import type. Or you can go to File, References, Xref Scene, and click on Add. Select the file and click Open. The file should be placed in this place exactly. The Xref files can't be selected or moved. They are just references to the original files. You can import as many files as Xrefs as you want. You can also enable and disable them, make them visible or invisible, and you can remove them entirely. Now it is time to save the file and see its size after I implemented the method 3. You can see that its size is being reduced significantly. Let's check what the render will look like. Nothing has changed, same as the original one. That is all for today's video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video if you found it helpful. And if you have any question or want to see more topics covered, let me know in the comment section.